Thank you all for coming. We'll get started. I think Kenny's passed out the release. And this is a very exciting day for us in the athletic department. And a big thank you, first of all, to Jim Murphy, who's the head of the NCAA sports marketing for Adidas. He's got a team that I hope you'll introduce, if you wouldn't mind.
Jeremy Lowy, who heads up our asset in Louisville, kind of on the ground, works with the university directly. Jake Parks heads up our product marketing for our football jerseys. Matty Merrill designs our football jerseys. Dan Bruin works on our kind of graphic and our identities within football. And then Jeremy Dahl hands up our brand communication in regards to our brand. So we're excited to have these guys here, and we've spent a few days interacting.
Jeremy's in Indianapolis. Everybody else is in Portland.
Yep. We're all out of Portland, and Jeremy's here in Indianapolis and services Louisville on a day-to-day basis.
But I first want to say thank you for the generosity you've shown, for the confidence you've had in our department. And we've been a partner since 1998, so we're going into our 17th year. And to be able to extend it at this type of a level and to be in the top five in the country for any brand, I want you to know how appreciative we are of what you've done. And it's a very innovative contract, and it's one that I think we both get to grow together. And we, as we've done for many, many years, we always want to be on the cutting edge of everything we do. And I know you do too. Yep. And I think that the leaps and bounds that Adidas has made in the last decade has been phenomenal. And we certainly want to be part of that wave.
Appreciate it.
So I'm going to turn it over to you.
Yeah. Well, first off, I want to thank Tom Durch, the athletic administration, and the coaching staff. Obviously great people here. Very positive culture. It's very infectious, and we're glad to be continuing that partnership here at the University of Louisville. You know, our goal at Adidas is really to help athletes perform better, and we look forward to that continual partnership with the University of Louisville in providing some of the best performance footwear, accessories, and apparel to the University of Louisville, to their athletes, and to their student fan base as well. So, like I said, excited about the opportunity, and appreciate the time spent on the contract, and looking forward to an exciting partnership in the future.
Brent Seabaum joins me up here. Brent is our Associate Athletic Director for External Affairs and works pretty much daily with the licensing, marketing, merchandising, things like that with all our apparel. And he did the nuts and bolts of this contract and worked pretty much on a day-to-day basis with Jim and their entire staff. And so I commend you on a job well done. And I know our coaches are very excited about it, and you'll have opportunities to talk with them if you want. But any questions?
Yeah, I mean, I think it's a continued partnership that we've had for a long time, and through, as Tom mentioned, we've been together since 1997, and we've seen the success of their program, and we're appreciative to be a part of that. This is more of a reflection of a lot of things encompassing, the apparel, the licensing deals, the marketing interaction. So it's a combination of a lot of things to kind of invigorate our partnership and really do some things that the university wants to move forward with, and I think the contract reflects that.
Were there discussions with other companies during this process?
No, there was not. No. We wanted to make sure Adidas had the first shot because they were the incumbent. They've done a marvelous job for us in the past, and we know we can grow together and both of us get better in the future. So we had a number in mind that where we wanted to be, where we felt we've earned that right, fortunately they agreed with us. And so we were able to settle on a number that's extremely generous, but it allows us to grow as a department. And the number one objective I had going into this entire thing was, how do we ensure that our student athletes have the premier apparel as we move forward, uniforms and apparel as we move forward, and give them their support. And this contract will accomplish all those things.
Where does this place your brand, Tom, nationally?
I'd leave that for somebody else to answer. I hope it's near the top. I think the thing we've tried to do here is have a very comprehensive athletic department. We wanted to be good in everything. We said last year when we had the year of the Cardinal, which was a very special year, we wanted to try to build on that and have lots of years of the Cardinal. Now, we know that it's very difficult to reach those heights, but if we could be on a consistent basis across the board and be good and everything, I think that would be very appealing, not only to the national audience that we have, but most importantly to our partners here at Adidas. And I think that's what caught their eye, is that we went across the board with all of our sports with excellence. Well, we've changed our color to orange. No, that's our one agreement we do have. That is not happening.
Yes, I think you'll see a lot of exciting things in the future. Obviously, you know, I want to keep that between us right now, but I think, you know, and Tom talking about the partnership, it allows us to really do some of those things. And so all we can kind of say is that, you know, I hope the Louisville fan base is, you know, excited with some of the things they're about to see in the next few years, and we're excited as well. So,
Eric, a lot of things that have been born out of this new relationship is our move to the ACC. And to say they're a very aggressive partner is an understatement. And so that's what we're really excited about, because we have such a growth curve in front of us that we're excited about and can't wait to be a part of that. But we want to make sure that we always remember how great the Big East was to us and the American and also the Conference USA.
Do you think the success of the athletic department as a whole the last couple of years played a big part in this deal?
I think you'd have to ask Jim that.
You know, I'd say absolutely. I mean, you know, for us in any college market, you know, a lot of the universities have a lot of rich history and tradition, and we respect that. But a lot of universities, you know, pushing forward and evolving, and you know, Louisville exemplifies that of keeping to tradition and history, but also pushing into the future. And as a brand, that's where we want to go as well. And so, a lot of our ideas and our values and our mindsets of when we went into this negotiation, this contract, was we aligned on a lot of things on where we wanted to go together. And in any partnership, you have to get each group has to get something out of it. And I think that's you know, clear in this contract, and we're excited about the future because I think we're both on the same page as far as, you know, where we want to go, both from an Adidas branded standpoint, but also from a Louisville, you know, apparel standpoint. So we're excited.
Have you been encouraged at how Louisville has embraced the brand and really, you know, with the jerseys and everything, they really embraced it all the way back?
Yeah, I mean, it's first class here. You know, it really is a community. That's what I've picked up during my time here. You know, it's a partnership. It's about family here. We support each other. We can have transparent conversations with each other, and ultimately know that we're steering towards the same goal. And so, you know, we appreciate the fact that they will step out once in a while, and you know, we want to do more. It's human nature, you know. So, you know, we're excited about the future. Yeah, I mean, that's the big goal we talked about is that I don't think we have an issue here as far as the fan base and a attention to the university. You know, our focus together is making sure that the other 49 states know the Louisville brand, and it's our job to help the university get there. And, you know, our team here, you know, spent a lot of time this week on trying to understand, you know, what the objectives are moving in the ACC, the campaigns and stuff, and how can we help just extend that partnership and use our assets to be able to get that consistent message out together.
Where is that now? I mean, how widely can you find Louisville merchandise?
I can't give you really geographic. I mean, I'm sure it's not in every door in the state, but not really every brand is. Any university, the e-commerce business, the internet business has really changed that. You know, not only on the NFL side or the NHL side, you know, those player numbers aren't always in retail anymore. And so, you know, the internet business has really taken over that fan can buy that product anytime he wants and necessarily doesn't have to go down the street to buy it. So, you know, from a national standpoint, as far as licensing, we're always trying to push the envelope and get them into new doors across the retail channels. But from a digital and marketing standpoint, in regards to athletics, you know, that's where you're going to see a big nationwide push from our side.
Notre Dame is switching to Under Armour, and Pitt and NC State are the only other two schools in the ACC that come to mind that are Adidas. How important is this third school in that league to have Adidas represent them?
Yeah, I mean, you know, actually, the University of Louisville and NC State, Pittsburgh is not an Adidas school. You know, obviously the ACC is a great conference, and the fact that Louisville's heading in there really positions us well to be able to capitalize on that. You know, we don't have a full breadth of, you know, all the schools like some of our counterparts, but, you know, we want to work with the top premier schools within those conferences and help activate and tell our stories together. Instead of 8 or 9 schools within the conference, you know, it's focusing on that one or two programs that we can really invest with and really make get awareness to the brand.
Can you give us a number of how many Division I schools you are affiliated with?
I want to say it's close to probably about 120. 120. It was expiring. You know, yeah, 2015 is around the corner tomorrow. So if anyone, takes some time to get through the nuts and bolts. And as Tom talked about, it was a very intricate contract and unique in some ways. And so it takes a little bit of time, and you want to get on the forefront of that. But you know, we would have done it, you know, a year ago if we wanted to. I mean, it wasn't necessarily timing. It was more, we had no doubts that we wanted to be with the University of Louisville, and it was just a matter of getting together and sitting down and figuring out what we want to do.
Tom, how much of your consideration here is about the dollar thing, and how much of it is trying to make this more of a national brand?
Well, the national brand is very important. The dollar, I would say the dollar figure is probably the third thing. He doesn't want to hear that, but after we signed it already, so it's good. You know, ensuring the student athletes and making sure that all their needs are met with the latest, best equipment there is and uniforms, that's the most important thing, because that's where our true reward comes. That's where our true responsibility is to those kids. And so I'm very confident that's been met. We've hit that, we've passed that bar. The finances are great. Don't get me wrong. It's terrific, and their generosity is so appreciated, as I mentioned before, because we'll be able to invest that in many different things. But we've got so many new opportunities that they're really going to embrace us in, because Adidas is an international company, a huge international company. With us opening Ken's new soccer stadium that will be second to none in this country for college soccer, we have great opportunities to really turn that into something special from a branding standpoint. You know, from Bobby, you know, we all got to remember one thing. The first blackout, whiteout, redout, greenout was right here. Bobby did that. He did that against West Virginia. That was the first one ever done. And so we've been on the creative side of it. You know, we took a break from about 7 years on that, but we're going to kick back into gear on that. And we really appreciate it. But, no, I would say if you put it in order, I'd say number one would be the student athletes and what they're going to get out. Number two would be certainly our brand, and number three would be the financial part of it. I can't believe anybody would criticize. I can't believe there's any critics out there. I've not seen any, to be honest with you. No, I would just say we've got to do our best to continue to build our program, to build our brand, and ensure that the success of this program, because it's so meaningful to so many people in this area, this region, this state, and in the state of Indiana also. Brent, go ahead.
I guess overall, you know, the five-year partnership, a figure was reported earlier today, but the five-year partnership in total value that we would project as the university is around $39 million. And that figure is subjective and calculated different with every university and every brand, but that's at retail value of the products, the cash investment, the extra marketing activation investments, what we aspire to do as far as postseason performance. Licensing revenues have skyrocketed the last 2 years, so just the merchandise revenues are all forecasted into that. But that's our projection in total.
What was the open
number? I don't have that handy. From the 2009 extension, we don't have that with
How
us.
How much of that is cash?
Approximately 7.7.
Of the 39? Mm-hmm. And is that payable over a period of years or?
Across the 5 years.
Tom, you mentioned it's money that's going to be invested. Do you have any kind of ideas on which ones way you want to invest it in particular?
No, really don't. We'll sit back and look at that. We're in our budgeting process right now anyway for the next month.